video editing takes up a lot of space, and before you know it, your computer's internal hard drive is filled up and you can't create anymore. It's all helpful data, but a lot of it's just render cache that you don't need to keep. So let me show you how to quickly delete the render cache clip files from DaVinci Resolve. Let's cut to the chase and go under the hood. Open Find or Search on a Mac using the shortcut Command F. This is going to prompt a search field where you can type in cache clip in parentheses with no spaces. Now you can select name matches cache clip, and that should perfectly limit your results. I think you can do something similar on Windows with the Explorer, but I couldn't tell you. I'm a Mac guy. A quick bonus tip while we're over here in Finder, it's a great idea always to turn on underneath the View menu, Show Path Bar, and Show Status Bar. This is going to let you know where you're at on your Mac at all times, and it's also going to let you know how much space you have left available on that drive. Now, each of these random numbered folders contain hundreds of files that DaVinci Resolve creates anytime you add effects or your computer just needs help to play back video in real time. However, Resolve can always recreate them the next time you open a project. So let's delete those now and save some space. And now, also just so you know, if you set your playback with render cache set to smart, and Resolve actually calls this background cache in the project setting, so just so you know, smart equals background to Blackmagic. Anyways, it'll start caching with those clips you're currently working with as soon as you pause playback and 5 seconds pass. Or it could be less if you change this to less time over in project settings, master settings. And if you just want to delete the render cache for the specific project that you're working on, you can go up to the playback menu and click Delete Render Cache All. Now, if you'd like to change the location that DaVinci Resolve writes the render cache files to, you've got two ways to do this. First, you could set it globally, meaning once you set this, the cache files are always going to go there unless you override it with the second method. So to set a cache file location globally, go to Preferences, under System, Media Storage, and here you can add and remove specific folders. The first one's going to be for your cache, and it probably should be your internal drive, and ideally it would be an SSD. The next option to change the media storage location is to open your project settings. Shift-9 is a great shortcut, but it's the cog icon in the lower right portion of the screen. Go to Master Settings and down to Working Folders, and here you can change the cache file's location for just that specific project. Now, changing the media storage location is only for new renders. And if you're new here, I want to welcome you. This is Creative Video Tips. I'm Chadwick, and this channel is here to help you craft stories to make a difference and stand out. So if you're into that, click subscribe right down below right now. But more importantly, if you want to learn more useful DaVinci Resolve tips, click the playlist that I've got on screen right now. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.